Albert Camus said, "You will never be happy if you continue to search for what happiness consists of." So the only way to attain this emotion is by abandoning the pursuit forever? Is life really that simple? The drive everybody has to make any decision they make is to find the reward of happiness, the emotion that has no source except within oneself. If I knew this all along, how did I fall in the trap of looking for something that wasn't there? It is I who was found searching for happiness, blinded by social survival and the fear of how others perceived me. The empathetic and sympathetic kid I once was became confused and was trapped by the need to prove himself in the eyes of others. I became paralyzed, only being able to see myself through my own crippled eyes. The desire to be loved and looked up to by the world blurred my perspectives and forced me to be untrue to myself, to abandon any sense of me growing inside. Uncertain of how I could find this rewarding emotion caused me to only see the skin on the entire apple. I saw myself hanging out with people only because of their social hierarchy I seemed to want so badly. I lost touch within myself, and despite the feeling of happiness I never received, I continued to ruin the relationships with friends that made me feel good about myself, to chase around people who made me feel like dirt. This paradox of getting opposite results of my intentions was not as complicated when I was younger. The passion and love for piano I used to have never failed to cheer me up when I was sad. Every time I played, I felt this rush of the power of music. In first grade, when my teacher, Mrs. Lerner, introduced me to math, my face would glow in excitement because I loved the fact that I was finally learning about something concrete. Soccer in fourth grade until eighth grade brought me so much amusement, and not once did I play the game without having the time of my life. Now that enthusiasm for piano, numbers, and soccer has become diluted, where nothing seems to consistently make me smile. The fact that I was constantly growing farther and farther from myself pushed me away from my past, and I became dissatisfied by all the events taking place in my life. I always felt I could be doing something better. So the question remained, is happiness attainable when one is looking? Hands in the pockets of my jacket, I would listen to my mind racing in every direction. The feeling of how vast the size of the planet is and how we are all just particles of nothingness in a universe of oblivion would be overwhelming. Then the feelings of guilt would come, thinking of my 83-year-old grandma telling me to live in each second because of how short life is. These feelings poured from everywhere in my mind, mixing and twisting into this amalgamation of emotions I didn't understand. Giving to the homeless down the streets in Berkeley or San Francisco was not reconsidered for a second when the instantaneous feeling of happiness of another less fortunate brought me so much pleasure. Life was so simple. I gave out of the kindness of my heart, and in return, I felt good about myself. Kieran sat there alone, eating his egg salad sandwich his mom packed him for lunch, when a bully came up to him and pushed his sandwich right into his humiliated face and started laughing. Yellow thickness dripped from his tearing face as I watched. I stood there and did nothing, because who would I be if I stood up for the weird kid at school? My fear of outside judgment submerged any sense of integrity I had up to the time when I was 10. The very me was sacrificed for an anticipated feeling of friendship of this asshole I never even received. I lost sight of my sense of self that I used to have. I drifted away from the one person I could always rely on. I wish I could give up the search for an answer for how to attain happiness and instead rely on my inside self to proceed into the unforeseeable future, when I could put the search for happiness aside and just live every moment like it is all that matters. I will finally experience happiness with my eyes wide open.